Okay, so assalamualaikum dan selamat petang. So untuk video ini, I will be explaining how to calculate pH of acidic and alkaline buffer. So sebelum ini kita dah belajar how to calculate pH for strong acid, strong base, weak acid, weak base, and now kita akan ada acidic buffer dan juga alkaline buffer. So before we go into the formula, ini formula ya yang awak perlu gunakan. We look at how do we derive the formula, this formula here. Okay, so basically acidic buffer is a mixture of weak acid and its conjugate. So we need to find the concentration of H+. Sebab apa H+? Sebab kita nak kira pH kat bawah ni. So pH is the concentration of H+, that's why kita kena cari H+. So untuk cari concentration of H+, first kali tengok equation ini, this is ini adalah dissociation of weak acid. Weak acid dissociate into H+ and juga ethanoic ion, and then kita mix it with salt. Ini adalah sodium ethanoate. We mix sodium ethanoate completely dissociate to form sodium ion dan juga ethanoic ion. So bila kita mix dua ini akan jadi buffer. So guna equation ini, bila kita masukkan ke dalam concentration of H, ethanoic acid and also ethanoic ion is high in concentration. So bila kita tulis equation ini dalam bentuk equilibrium expression, Ka equals to H plus and ethanoic ion over acid. So ini adalah equilibrium expression for acid dissociation. Kita dah belajar minggu lepas. So for this Ka equals to product over reactant, kita susun semula. Sebab kita, kenapa nak susun semula? Because kita nak cari H plus concentration. So this H plus concentration equals to Ka darab dengan weak acid over salt. So ini salt. Lepas itu kita try, okay, saya gantikan. Okay, this one acid saya ganti dengan kataan acid. Yang ini salt saya gantikan dengan salt. Kemudian kita negatif logkan semua ini. Dalam equation ini kita negatif logkan. Negatif log H+, negatif log Ka, negatif log acid over salt. So bila awak negatif logkan ini semua, apa yang akan berlaku? Negatif log H+ akan menjadi pH. Negatif log Ka will become pKa. Negative log acid over salt akan jadi plus log salt over acid. So ini adalah formula untuk kira pH of acidic buffer. So pH equals to pKa tambah log salt over acid. So untuk mengira, for calculating the pH, what do you need is actually Ka value. Ka value will be given to you in the question if you need to calculate pH. So Ka value akan diberi. Negative log Ka, you get pKa. Salt concentration and acid concentration. So dalam soalan akan diberi concentration of acid and salt. So awak just perlu masukkan directly. So kena ingat concentration is mole of solute over volume of solution in liter. Okay, this is for acidic buffer. So if we go into alkaline buffer, formulanya sama juga. Awak akan ada base. This is weak base ammonia dissociate in water to produce ammonium ion plus hydroxide ion. This is salt, ammonium chloride dissociate completely. So bila awak mix dua ini akan jadi buffer, basic buffer. So basic buffer, kita ada ammonia and kita ada ammonium high in concentration. So bila kita tulis basic dissociation constant, alkaline dissociation constant kat sini KB base. So ammonium concentration darab dengan hydroxide concentration over ammonia. So awak akan dapat benda yang sama seperti tadi. Susun semula OH sebab kita nak cari OH. So OH, lepas tu saya ganti salt dan juga base ke dalam equation. Negatif logkan semua ini, you will get negative log OH- bersamaan dengan POH, negative log KB bersamaan dengan PKB, dan juga negative log base over salt will become plus log salt over base. So jika awak tengok formula ini sama macam formula asid tadi, bezanya adalah ini pKa, pKb dan log salt sentiasa di atas, bawah ini it's either acid or base. So you will get POH. To get pH, you can use this formula 14 minus POH equals to pH, ataupun boleh guna Kw. Okay? So that is basic buffer. To summarize, this is all the formula used to calculating pH. We have strong acid, weak acid, strong base, weak base, acidic buffer and basic buffer. Okay? So formula ini mostly is given to you, ada diberi dalam senarai rumus for your exam, but practice is crucial. It will make you more skill bila menjawab inilah. So we have strong acid, weak acid, strong base, weak base, acidic buffer dan juga basic buffer. Okay, kita tengok contoh soalan. So for example, contoh soalan, the pH of a buffer that consists of 0.55 molar metanoic ion and 0.63 molar of sodium metanoate. Okay, so kita ada dua concentration. This is acid concentration and this is base concentration. And then the pKa is given to you. So substitute into the formula. Senang sahaja, 3.74 masuk ke dalam log salt over acid. Which one is salt? This one is salt, this one is acid. So masukkan salt and acid, 0.63 and 0.55 ke dalam. So bila awak kira, you get 3.8. Itu adalah pH of the buffer. Peringatan dekat sini, usually it can either give you pKa terus ataupun diberi Ka, awak kena negative logkan sendiri. And then make sure that the concentration is mol over liter. Sometimes the question will give you in mass, so awak kena cari mol bahagi dengan volume. Itu mencari molarity. So you get pH 3.8. Kalau it is basic buffer ataupun alkaline buffer, apa yang awak perlu lakukan, you get POH. Awak kena cari pH 14 tolak POH. So awak dapat pH. So itu sahaja untuk video ini.